Tax non-compliance is among key factors that contribute to revenue leakages in the country, which affects resource allocation and development. In a bid to improve and strengthen domestic revenue mobilization, Uganda joined about 120 countries to automatically exchange information about investors while identifying cases of tax evasion.
The earlier we get the oil when we are still using, the better for us, and that's what we want to do. When they are still saying bring this and we are transitioning slowly, transition means you are moving smoothly without disruptions. So we are still using it, and that's what we want. Since they are finite resources, it can get depleted. By the time it's getting depleted, we shall have moved away.
It's sustainable development goals, particularly in relation to energy efficiency. In fact, this country, 95% is renewables. We just need to make sure that people use the electricity we have. And therefore, how do we provide, like I said, incentives to them through social tariffs? The government has a new energy policy. There's a new energy bill in the pipeline and many other things that are doing. I think today's meeting and this week's event on energy and renewable energy and energy efficiency and e-mobility is a statement by the government, and ours is to support the vision of the government.
According to the Commissioner General, Uganda Revenue Authority, John Rajoki Musinguzi, Uganda has so far recovered 200 billion shillings since they rolled onto the system. He was speaking during the launch of the voluntary disclosure of information aimed at overcoming challenges of cross-border taxation. The Deputy Secretary to the Treasury, Patrick Ochailab, tasked commercial banks to avail financial details of investors to URA so as to ease the clearance process. The automatic exchange of information, voluntary disclosure of information system, has been described as a powerful tool that could generate additional taxable revenues for the country. Story by Josephine Lonkuse for the news.